In this video, we're going to talk about the nomenclature of elements and monatomic ions. Nomenclature just means saying the names of the, well, in this case, elements and monatomic ions. And so we're going to learn how to say the names or write the names and also look at names and predict, and well, not predict and tell what the formula is from the name. So let's start with elements. Elements are just, the name of them is just the same name as is in the periodic table. And the formula, it's just the symbol that's in the periodic table. Easy as that. The only thing is that there are seven elements who are diatomic. That is, their elemental form is diatomic. Di is two, atomic means atoms. And they are hydrogen, oxygen, fluorine, bromine, iodine, nitrogen, and chlorine. And if you write them in this order, it just makes a silly little mnemonic device. You know, Hofbräunkel spells that Hofbräunkel, nonsense word, right? But if for some reason it seems easy to remember, Hofbräunkel. Remember Hofbräunkel? You have the seven diatomic elements. What it means is that if we say hydrogen, just the word hydrogen, it means H2, two atoms of hydrogen attached to each other. Same thing for oxygen, fluorine, bromine, iodine, nitrogen, or chlorine. Now, if we wanted to say just a single atom of hydrogen, we'd say something like atomic hydrogen or atomic oxygen and so on. But if we just say hydrogen, we mean H2. If we just say chlorine, we mean Cl2. And that's all there is to that. So if you see a symbol, the name is just the name of the element, except for the seven diatomics, Hofbräunkel, just remember there's two of those guys. All right, so we know that in a neutral atom, the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons. And each proton has a positive one charge, each electron has a negative one charge. If we have the same number of positive charges and negative charges, they cancel each other out and there's a zero charge overall. Now, if an atom gains extra electrons or loses some of its electrons, now it's gonna have an overall charge. If the atom gains electrons so that it has more electrons than protons, then it will have an overall negative charge. And the size of that negative charge, you can get just by taking how many electrons you have minus the number of protons. So let's say we have six protons and seven electrons that have a negative one charge. Now, if you have less electrons than protons, if the atom lost electrons somehow, then there's more positive charges than negative charges, and overall it will have a positive charge. We call that a cation. By the way, if it has a negative charge, it's called an anion. A positive charge is called a cation. So if it lost some electrons, then it's going to have an overall positive charge, and that size of that positive charge is just the protons minus the electrons. So let's say there's six protons and four electrons. Six minus four is two. The charge would be positive two. So visually, kind of like this. Lithium has three protons, so it has three positive charges in its nucleus. Remember, you guys, neutrons don't have any charges. They don't affect this. So three positive charges from the nucleus, and if it's neutral, by the way, the way that you know that it's neutral is if there's no charge written as a superscript to the right. Here, there's nothing written up here. So we know that it has zero charge, and that means the number of electrons is the same as the number of protons. So if we have three protons, we have three electrons. Now, if we had lithium with a positive one charge, that means there's one more proton than electrons. Now, we can't change the number of protons because that would change what element it is, right? So lithium, if it's lithium, then it's lithium, and it has three protons no matter what. If it has a positive one charge, that means it only has two electrons. It lost one of its electrons. On the other hand, if we could give lithium an extra electron so that it had four electrons, it would have a negative charge. The positive charge is written up here. We don't write a one, it's implied. If it's more than one, by the way, if this was a positive two charge, we would write a two in front of the plus sign. Two in front of the negative sign if this is two negative. But here there's four electrons, three protons, so there's an overall negative one charge. This is an anion, this is a cation, this is a neutral element. So when you say the name of a monatomic cation, positively charged, monatomic means there's just one atom, right? So one atom with a positive charge, then it's just the same name as the element. However, that element can form cations with different charges, then you must use a Roman numeral to say what that charge is. On the other hand, if the element only forms one cation, only one type of charge, then you're not allowed to use a Roman numeral in its name. How do you know if an element can form more than one type of cation? Memorize this table right here. This lists all of the elements that form cations that only form one charge. They're written in here in this periodic table. So, you know, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, cadmium, silver, zinc, gallium, aluminum, so on. If it's a metal and it forms a positive one charge, or excuse me, any positive charge, then it's one of these blanks in here. And when you say the name of that cation, you have to use a Roman numeral because that means it can form more than one type of cation. And now it ends up that metals to the left of this staircase form cations, anions to the right of this, nonmetals to the right of this staircase form anions. So we're talking about cations here, monatomic cations, we're always talking about metals to the left of the staircase. So memorize which metals only form one charge, hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, and so on. Beryllium's not here because it can do other things. It's kind of strange. So memorize this. So if we were saying the name of iron with a positive 3 charge, we would call it iron 3. When you say it, just say iron 3 is how you say it. On the other hand, if you saw the words iron 3, that would tell you that it's iron, which is Fe, and that Roman numeral 3 lets you know that it has a positive 3 charge. On the other hand, if it's a gallium with a plus 3, it's just gallium is what we call it, or sometimes we'll call it the gallium ion. And if you're told that you have the gallium ion, then you know it, then the way you know its charge is, you know, from this table here, plus 3. Now, there's a pattern here. Notice everything in the first column, column 1A, has a positive 1 charge. Everything except beryllium in column 2A has a plus 2 charge. And everything in column, well, not everything, but the first two, aluminum and gallium, these guys form a plus 3 charge. And the others you just remember. The transition metals, scandium, zinc, cadmium, and silver form plus 3, plus 2, plus 2, and plus 1. So Roman numeral, if it's a cation and it's not on this table, if it's a cation and it is on the table, no Roman numeral allowed. And that's all there is to that. There is one sort of exception that you just have to memorize, and that's mercury. Mercury 2 is just what you think. It's a mercury atom with a positive 2 charge. It lost 2 electrons. However, mercury 1 is kind of strange. It is not, as you would think, Hg with a plus 1 charge, but rather there's 2 of them, and it's always like this. There's 2 mercury atoms. Well, kind of like one of those diatomics. It is a diatomic, but it's a cation. And each of these mercury atoms has a plus 1, so overall there's a 2 positive charge. You will not see Hg plus. That's wrong. If it's mercury 1, it'll always be this. And the name of this, Hg2, 2 plus, is mercury 1. So just memorize that. Just put it on your card. Now, the name of a monatomic anion, it's just the name of the element with its ending changed to IDE. So sulfur with a negative 2 charge, if you look back on that table, you see that sulfur forms a negative 2 charge. It's called sulfide. If you see the word sulfide with IDE, that means this. Watch out. We're going to see in a little bit when we do names of other things that if we replace this D with a T, then it's something totally different. So be real careful. So nitrogen with a negative 3 charge, we call it nitride. If we see the word nitride, that tells us that it's N nitrogen with a 3 negative charge.